Welcome back to the Lipstickholics YouTube channel. I'm Huda Naveed and today I'm here with a teddy. But no, I'm here with a review for you all. But since I'm filming this video on 14th of Feb, so I wanted to feature Mr. Fluffy here. Say hi to Mr. Fluffy here. Okay, so I'm here today reviewing one of the most hyped foundation from 2018, and the product I'm talking about is Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Full Coverage Foundation. This is the one, and I'm going to talk about it today, and I'm going to review it and demo it and, you know, show it and, you know, basically tell everything I like or hate about this foundation. Before we get started with the review, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and yes, don't forget to turn on the bell notifications so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. Okay, so let's just start talking about this product, and I'm going to start off with the packaging. It comes in this large glass sort of packaging, glass bottle I can say, and it looks like this. Let me just, you know. Okay, so this is how the packaging looks. It comes with a nice doe foot applicator, a very large one. And let me just show you how it looks. Okay. This applicator is actually very useful, and I like it because I don't have to pour the foundation on my hand or on my brush directly. I can simply use this applicator to apply the desired amount of product on my face and then blend it in with my favorite sponge or brush or even with my fingers. So this is really nice. So this is a 23 ml bottle, and it says that this foundation is cruelty free and vegan, which is great. And you can see the ingredient list right here on the bottle. Let me just show you. The shade that I'm reviewing is F6, and the shade name is written right here on the top. Let me just show you once again. If my camera focuses, because I'm using a new camera today, and I hope it does the job well. And okay, here is the shade name. Okay, so now I'm just going to apply this foundation in front of you and then talk about this product further. Okay, so I'm just going to prime my skin using a Smashbox primerizer. Just look at the amazing coverage it's providing. Let's just blend the rest of it. Okay, so I know right now the foundation might be looking a bit lighter for my skin tone or a bit too white. That is because of the artificial lighting that I am using, but in person it looks so much better and so natural. I've shared a couple of pictures on my Instagram in which I'm wearing this foundation in daylight, and I will continue sharing more pictures on my Instagram in which I will be wearing this foundation in daylight. So it looks much better in daylight and in person. So I have applied and blended the foundation in front of you, and it blends really easily, I can tell. Now I'm just going to do the rest of my makeup and be back. Okay, so I'm back after doing the rest of my makeup, and I have not used any setting spray. I have not applied my setting powder, and I have not applied the concealer because I wanted you guys to see how the foundation actually looks on the skin. So apart from that, I have applied blusher and eye makeup and eyebrow powder and lipstick, of course. About this foundation, let me just tell you, this is super easy to blend. It can be blended with a sponge, it can be blended with a brush, or you can use your fingers to blend it in. The consistency of this foundation is sort of thin, but not very thin or runny. It's like a medium thin, I would say, and it applies easily with this applicator that comes along, and you can simply blend it using any of your favorite brushes or sponge or just your fingers. Now, the coverage this foundation provides is almost full, and I love the coverage it provides. As you can see, it has concealed almost all the imperfections on my face, but I do feel the need to apply and use my Conceal and Define concealer because I can still see my dark circles, but this is something that I am noticing personally because I have these horrible dark circles. Apart from that, it does conceal most of the imperfections and is almost a full coverage foundation, and you can say a complete full coverage foundation, and I love this sort of coverage. Now, this foundation does not look cakey or patchy at all, but I do feel that it does enhance your dry patches a bit, so you need to use a very good moisturizer before applying this foundation or prime your face very well, otherwise it will enhance your dry patches. I also noticed that after 5 to 6 hours of wear, my foundation did settle in this double chin area. Apart from that, it looked perfect and it was flawless throughout the day. Once again, I would say you need to prepare your skin well and moisturize it well and make sure it is not dehydrated or flaky. Otherwise, the foundation will accentuate your dry patches or dryness on your skin. Apart from that, I love the finish it provides. It's a really nice matte finish, but not a dead matte sort of finish. It's a really nice soft semi-matte sort of finish, which I actually love, and this is something I love about this foundation. One thing I would like to mention is that it does look really nice in pictures too. I think it has some sort of photo finish properties too, but I love how it looks and appears in pictures, and it looks really nice in person too. Even though this is a full coverage foundation, but I love how lightweight it feels on the skin. I mean, I don't get that feeling that I'm having a very heavy coat or tons and tons of layers of foundation on my face. It does feel very lightweight, and I love this thing about it too. The staying power of this foundation is pretty great, and it does stay on me for about 10 hours or more easily. I can say till the end of the day easily. But once again, I would say it does tend to slightly settle in your fine lines. So you need to be careful about that, because I did notice that it does settle in my double chin area. Other than that, it looks flawless and great. So I am impressed with the staying power too. All in all, I can say I love this foundation. I love its finish, I love its coverage, I love how it looks and feels on the skin, but there are a few points that I don't like about this foundation. One being that you need to make sure that your skin is properly moisturized and primed before applying this foundation, or it can tend to accentuate or make your dry patches a bit prominent, which is something you won't like. Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Foundation is available on beautybar.pk and Tam Beauty and other websites in Pakistan for Rs. 2000 only, and it is available on Makeup Revolution International website for £9 if I'm right. Apart from the minor bad points, I totally love this foundation, and for its price, it's definitely amazing, and I surely recommend you to try this out. Make sure to follow me on all my social accounts. I have shared the link below. And if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Make sure to leave your lovely comments. And yes, most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. You'll be seeing me very soon in another video on the Lipstickholics YouTube channel. Till then, take care and goodbye.